Now in this session, we will solve one problem on amalgamation. Let us read the question first. The following are the balance sheet as on 31st March 2012 of Nisha Limited and Usha Limited. Liability side, equity share capital rupees 100 per share, 15% debenture, reserve fund, employees provident fund, sundry creditors, profit and loss account. Asset side, land and building, plant and machinery, stock, debtors, bank. Miscellaneous expenses not written off, in that we are having debenture issue expenses. The two companies agrees to amalgamate and form a new company, Messrs. Ujala Limited. So the name of the purchasing company is Messrs. Ujala Limited, which takes over the assets and liabilities of both the companies. That means it is taking the assets and liabilities of both the companies. The authorized capital of Ujala Limited is rupees 20 lakh, consisting of 2 lakh equity shares of rupees 10 each. The assets of Nisha Limited are taken over at 90% of the book value, with the exception of land and building, which are accepted at book value. That means the purchasing company is taking the assets of Nisha Limited at 90% of the book value, except land and building. So here I have highlighted plant and machinery, stock and debtors. These assets are taken at 90% of the book value. Now, both the companies are to receive 10% of the net valuation of the respective business as goodwill. The purchase consideration is to be satisfied by Ujala Limited in its fully paid shares at 10% premium. In return of debentures of Nisha Limited, debentures of the same amount and denomination are to be issued by Ujala Limited. Close the books of Nisha Limited and Usha Limited. So first we have to calculate purchase consideration. And while calculating purchase consideration, first, we should always try the net payment method. Now, let us read this statement. It is telling that the purchase consideration is to be satisfied by Ujala Limited in its fully paid shares at 10% premium. So, it is telling that purchase consideration will be satisfied by fully paid shares and the shares will be at 10% premium. But it is not talking about the number of shares or the ratio of the number of shares. That means in this problem, the information about net payment is not available. You know, since the information about net payment is not available, we have to calculate purchase consideration under net assets method. So first step is we have to calculate purchase consideration under net assets method. So this will be our first step in the books of Nisha Limited, purchase consideration, and we will follow net assets method. These are the columns: particulars, amount, and assets taken over at revised value. So we have to take the assets which are taken over at revised value. Now for this we will refer the question. Now in Nisha Limited asset side, we are having land and building, which is 70,000. So land and building is taken at book value. So we will write the book value of land and building. So land and building 70,000. Now the next asset is plant and machinery. So this plant and machinery is taken at 90% of the book value. So the book value of plant and machinery is 2,20,000 and it is taken at 90% of the book value. So here we will write plant and machinery, the book value is 2,20,000 and 90% of that comes to 1,98,000. Then the next asset is stock. Stock again it is taken at 90% of book value. So we will write here stock 35,000 and 90% of 35,000 is 31,500. The next asset is debtors. Debtors, the book value is 25,000. So debtors 25,000 and it is taken at 90%. So 22,500. Now the next asset is bank. Bank is always taken at the book value. So we will write the book value of bank, which is 6,000. So this is my total assets, which is 3,28,000. Now next, liabilities taken over into bracket revised value. Now we will consider the liability side of the balance sheet. Now in liabilities, we have to take only the outside liability. So the first liability is 15% debenture, which is 40,000. Now if you will refer here, it is written that in return of debentures of Nisha Limited, debentures of the same amount and denomination are to be issued by Ujala Limited. That means this debenture is taken by the purchasing company at the book value. So we will take that debenture at book value. So 15% debenture, 40,000. Now let us consider the other liability. Now in the next outside liability is employees provident fund. The book value is 6,000. So we will take here employees provident fund 6,000. The next outside liability is sundry creditors. So sundry creditors, the book value is 30,000. So we will take sundry creditors 30,000. So the total liability is 76. Now this total assets minus total liability, we will get net valuation. Now here it is mentioned that 10% of the net valuation of the respective business as goodwill. So we will give 10% as a goodwill. So here we had taken 10% of the net valuation, that is 25,200 as goodwill. So my total purchase consideration will be 2,77,200. So this is my step number one. I have calculated purchase consideration. Now next step will be settlement of purchase consideration. Now there are two columns for this. One is more and another is amount. So here it is mentioned that purchase consideration is to be settled by fully paid shares at 10% premium. So that's the reason we will write here this purchase consideration amount is 2,77,200, and how it is settled? It is settled in the form of equity shares in Ujala Limited, which is given at 10% premium. So this completes my settlement of purchase consideration. Now once this is done, we have to prepare the necessary accounts. Now the accounts will be, the first account will be realization account. First account is realization account. The second account will be equity shareholders account. Last 10 lines you have to write equity shareholders account. So first account is realization account and second account is equity shareholder account. Then third account will be purchasing company. So the name of the purchasing company is Ujala Limited. So Mrs. Ujala Limited account. And the fourth account will be how the purchase consideration is settled. It is settled in equity share. So equity share in Ujala Limited. So totally there are four accounts. First account is realization account on one page. Last 10 lines equity shareholders account. Then on the next page, 5 lines purchasing company, that is Mrs. Ujala Limited account, and 5 lines equity share in Ujala Limited account. Now once the accounts are ready, we have to follow the steps. Now our step is balance sheet, PRS, PR, PRS. Now balance sheet stands for balance sheet transferred. So we will transfer the balance sheet. First we will take the asset side of the balance sheet. So first we will consider the asset side. Now in asset side we are having land and building, plant and machinery, stock, debtors and bank balance. Now all these assets will be transferred to the debit side of realization account at the book value, not at the revised value. Revised value is to be considered only while calculating purchase consideration. Now in realization we will be transferring the book value. So we will transfer this to realization account debit side. So realization account debit side, first we will write to land and building 70,000, to plant and machinery 2,20,000, to stock 35,000, to debtors 25,000, and to bank 6,000. So we had transferred the asset side. Now similarly we will take the liability side. Now in liability side, first we are having equity share capital. So this equity share capital will be transferred to the credit side of equity shareholders account. So here we will write in equity shareholders account by equity share capital 2 lakh. Next is 15% debenture. Now this 15% debenture is the outside liability. So it will be transferred to realization account credit side. So in realization account credit side I have written by 15% debenture 40,000. Next is reserve fund. Now this reserve will be transferred to equity shareholders account. So equity shareholders account credit side we will write by reserve fund 76,000. Next is employees provident fund and sundry creditors. Now both these are the outside liability. So this liability will also be transferred to realization account credit side. So realization account credit side by sundry creditors 30,000. By employees provident fund 6,000 and by sundry creditors 30,000. The next is profit and loss account. Now this is a reserve, so it will be transferred to equity shareholders account credit side. So by reserve fund, by profit and loss account 4,000. So this completes my balance sheet. Next, P stands for purchase consideration due. Now purchase consideration due, purchase consideration is due from the purchasing company. So the entry for that is purchasing company account debit to realization, that is Ujala Limited account debit to realization. So in Ujala Limited we will write on debit side to realization. An amount will be of purchase consideration that is 277,200, which we have already calculated. So here it is 2 realization. So in realization, it will be by Ujala Limited 277,200. So this completes my P. R stands for receiving purchase consideration. Now purchase consideration, it is received in the form of equity shares. So the entry will be equity shares in Ujala Limited debit, because it is coming in, and who is the giver? Ujala Limited. So to Ujala Limited. So the entry for receiving purchase consideration is equity share in Ujala Limited account debit to Ujala Limited. Now we will post this entry, equity share in Ujala Limited. So equity share in Ujala Limited, we will write to Ujala Limited 277,200. Here it is to Ujala Limited. So here it will be by equity share in Ujala Limited 277,200. So this completes my R. S stands for sale of assets not taken over, there is no transaction. P stands for payment of liability not taken over, there is no transaction. R stands for realization expenses paid by vendor company, there is no transaction. P stands for payment to preference shareholders, there is no transaction. R stands for realization account closed. Now we will close the realization account. The credit side total is 353,200 and the debit side total is 356,000. So which is the heavier total? 356. So I have written heavier total on both the side. 356. That means there is a loss. So by equity shareholder, there is a loss of 2,800 rupees. So this loss we will write here by equity shareholder loss, and this loss will be transferred to equity shareholder account. That is to realization account into bracket loss 2,800. So this completes my R, that is realization account close. Now S stands for settlement of equity shareholder. Now in settlement of equity shareholder, what we have to do, whatever equity shares we have received from Ujala Limited, this we will give it to the equity shareholders. So this shares will go out. So on credit side, we have to write by equity shareholder 277,200. So here it is by equity shareholder. So in equity shareholder, it will be, in equity shareholder, it will be to equity share in Ujala Limited 277,200. Now my all steps are completed. So we have to check whether all the accounts are coming equal. So this equity shareholders is equal. Similarly, Ujala Limited is closed and equity share in Ujala Limited is also closed. So this way we had closed the first company, that is Nisha Limited. Similarly, we have to close the second company, that is called Usha Limited. So again, our step number one will be, we have to calculate purchase consideration in the books of Usha Limited. So again, in the books of Usha Limited, we will be following net assets method for calculating purchase consideration. So in the books of Usha Limited, purchase consideration, net assets method, these are the columns, particulars, amount, assets taken over into bracket, revised value. Now we will just refer to the question. Now here the assets of Usha Limited are taken at book value. So we have to write book value of all the assets, that is plant and machinery, stock, debtors and bank balance. Debenture issue expenses, it is a fictitious asset and purchasing company never takes over the fictitious asset. So that will not come in the statement of purchase consideration. Only plant and machinery, stock, debtors and bank, we have to write the book value. So plant and machinery, book value is 1 lakh, stock book value is 18, debtors book value is 16 and bank book value is 2000. So total 1,36,000. Now less liabilities taken over into bracket revised value. So now we will refer to the liability. In liability, we are having only one outside liability, that is sundry creditors. The book value is 16,000. So we will write here creditors 16,000. So net valuation is 1,20,000. Again, here it is mentioned that we have to give 10% of the net valuation as goodwill. So we will be giving that 10% goodwill, that comes to 12,000. So purchase consideration is 1,32,000. Now, settlement of purchase consideration, mode and amount. Again, how the purchase consideration is settled? It is told that it is to be settled in the form of fully paid shares. So settlement of purchase consideration, it will be in the form of equity share in Ujala Limited, which is at 10% premium and the value is 1,32,000. Again, we have to prepare the accounts in the books of Usha Limited now. So the four accounts, first is realization account, then second is equity shareholders account. On one page, two account, realization account, last 10 lines, equity shareholders account. On the second page, 5 lines, purchasing company, that is Ujala Limited, and the remaining 5 lines, how the purchase consideration is settled in the form of equity share in Ujala Limited. So equity share in Ujala Limited. So these accounts are ready. Now we will be solving according to our steps. Again, same, our steps is what? Balance sheet, PRS, PR, PRS. Balance sheet stands for balance sheet transferred. So first we will transfer the asset side. Now in asset side, we are having plant and machinery, stock, debtors and bank. These assets will be transferred to the debit side of realization account. So on realization account, debit side, we will transfer these assets, that is plant and machinery 1 lakh, stock 18,000, debtors 16,000 and bank 2,000. Now here on the asset side, there is one fictitious asset called debenture issue expense. Now this debenture issue expense will be transferred to equity shareholders account. So here it will be transferred on the debit side of equity shareholders account. Here we will write to debenture issue expense 5,000. So this completes my asset side. Now we will take the liability side. In liability, again we are having equity share capital 1,20,000. So this equity share capital will be transferred to equity shareholder account credit side by equity share capital. Then the next is reserve fund. Reserve fund belongs to equity shareholder, so that will be transferred to the credit side of equity shareholder account. Next is creditors. Now creditors is an outside liability, so it will be transferred to realization account credit side, that is by creditors 16,000. So this completes my balance sheet. Next, P stands for purchase consideration due. So purchase consideration due, the entry is Ujala Limited account debit to realization account. So we will write it here, in Ujala Limited to realization, and in realization by Ujala Limited. The amount will be of purchase consideration, which we have already calculated. R stands for receiving purchase consideration. Now purchase consideration, how it is received? In the form of equity share. So this is coming in, so you have to debit that, and who is the giver? Ujala Limited. So the entry is equity share in Ujala Limited account debit to Ujala Limited. Now we will post this entry, equity share in Ujala Limited. So here I will write to Ujala Limited, and here it will be by equity shares in Ujala Limited. Amount will be amount of purchase consideration, that is 1,32,000 and 1,32,000. So this completes my R. Next is what? S. S stands for sale of assets not taken over, no transaction. P stands for payment of liability not taken over, no transaction. R stands for realization expenses paid by vendor company, no transaction. P stands for payment to preference shareholders, no transaction. R stands for realization account close. So I will close the realization account. First I will take the total of credit side. Credit side total is 1,48,000. Debit side total is 1,36,000. So credit side is heavier, so we will write heavier total on both the side, that is 1,48,000, here also 1,48,000. So the difference will be profit, which will be transferred to equity shareholders. So to equity shareholders account. Profit. So the profit will be 12,000 is the profit. Now this profit will be transferred to equity shareholder. It is to equity shareholder. So in equity shareholder, it will be by realization into bracket profit. So this completes my R. S stands for settlement of equity shareholder. Now how we will settle the equity shareholder? This equity share which we have received from Ujala Limited, we will give it to the equity shareholder. So credit what goes out? Credit side we will write by equity shareholder 1,32,000. Now here it is by equity shareholder. So in equity shareholder, it will be to equity share in Ujala Limited 1,32,000. So my all the steps are completed. My all accounts should come equal. Here it is 1,37,000, equity shareholder is equal. Here it is 1,32,000, Ujala Limited is equal, and equity shares in Ujala Limited is also equal. So in this way we had closed both the books. Thank you very much.